Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Welcome to Claudia God's Nuggets for the day. Praise the Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Today I'm going to just share what's in the Lord has laid in my heart for me to share with you. God bless you. Thank you for joining in with me. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. But before we begin to share just a little bit about God's word and what the Lord is speaking at this time, I want us to just enter into his presence with some praise. Praise the Lord. Bless his holy name. Hallelujah. And if you're ready, let's just worship God. I'm going to honor him, and then we're going to get right into the word. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I worship you, Almighty God. There is none like you. I worship you, O Prince of Peace, that is what I want to do. I give you praise, for you are my righteousness. I worship you, Almighty God, there is none like you. Dear Jesus, we love you so much. There is absolutely no one like you in all the earth. You are the great and mighty God. We love you, Jesus. We praise you, Jesus. We bless you. We celebrate you again today. Thank you for yet another day. Thank you for your goodness, your kindness, your favor, your love, your mercy, your provision. Thank you for what you've made available for us today. All of your favors we've experienced today. I bless you, Lord. I exalt you, exalt you, exalt you. I want to say thank you for the cross. Thank you for the blood of Jesus. Thank you for this life we have in you. Thank you for the presence of your precious Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for food on our tables. Thank you for shelter, for clothing. Thank you for your hedge of protection. Lord, your countless goodness in our lives. We give you praise. We honor you. There is no one like you. We worship you. All want to be in your presence more than anything. Blessed be your holy name. We surrender all to you. Lord, even as we're going into just the short study of your word, Father, we pray for your presence. I pray that you speak through me. Let it be your very own words. Lord, be glorified in this, oh God. And I pray that our hearts will be receptive to your truth, oh God. And let this word bear fruit in our lives. In the name of Jesus, let our hearts be our hearts that is sensitive to your voice, oh God. Hearkening to your voice. Glorify your name in this. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Bless his holy name. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So today we're sharing on hearkening to the voice of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. 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 I'm just going to read a very short scripture here, and we're going to talk about it and see what the Lord is saying. Praise the Lord. I'm reading from Isaiah 65, verse 12. I'm reading a B part of it. It says, I spoke and you did not hear. You did what was evil in my sight and chose what I did not delight in. And I'm going to read the consequence. It says, I will destine you for the sword, and all of you will kneel down to be slaughtered, because I called and you did not answer. So what is the focus on this? Is the focus, if we read from looking at this scripture, the focus is on the Lord speaking and we not listening. We don't listen, and then we end up doing what is unpleasant to him. I want to read another scripture to support that. I'm reading Isaiah 66, verse 2b. It says, verse 2b, it says, I will look favorably on this kind of person, one who is humble, submissive in spirit, and trembles at my word. I will look favorably on this kind of person, one who is humble, submissive in spirit, and trembles at my word. If you look at it, if we look at them side to side, you can see that it's like they are like opposing characteristics of a person and what God thinks about it, right? So we see here that the first one is the one that the Lord is speaking and they're not listening. They're not listening and then they're doing evil. The result of not listening to God is that we default in doing evil. And the other person, in verse 6, chapter Isaiah 66, it says, this kind of person who is humble and submissive. So there's the one that is not hearkening to the voice of the Lord, right? And the consequence that is going to come with that. And there's the one that is listening to the voice of the Lord. The Lord calls that person humble and submissive in spirit and trembles at his word. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I feel like this is the word the Lord wants for us at this time. We're at a time where there's so much going on out there. We hear so many different kinds of voices, right? We hear so many things. We hear what's going on in the news. We hear what's going on social media. There's a lot of opinions. People, there's a lot of opinion just flying everywhere, right? Whether you like it or not, you're going to hear something about something, right? But then there's that still quiet voice of the Holy Spirit inside of us. There's the voice of God inside of us, right? And so the Lord has told us how he will respond to both, either one of them. What are we listening to? What are we adhering to? What are we hearkening to, right? There's the one that he says, if you're submissive in spirit and you tremble at my word, meaning if you're listening to his voice, he says, I will look unto you favorably. Wow. I mean, think about the Lord favoring you. The Lord favoring you could be anything. If the president of a nation favors you, you know what that is. Now imagine the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He says, I will favor this one who walks humbly before me, who is submissive in spirit, who trembles at my word. Praise the Lord. We don't like the other part. The other part is talking about, he says the consequence is terrible. He says you'll be slaughtered, meaning terrible things are going to happen to you. So this is God's wrath, God's judgment on someone who is not listening to the voice of his Holy Spirit and who is going in the way of evil and sin versus somebody who is walking humbly with the Lord and listening to his voice. I mean, it's very clear. The Bible says, I said before you, life and death, even tells you what to choose. It says, choose life. So that's the circumstance we're seeing as we parallel these two scriptures, right? Humbly, walking humbly before the Lord. It means you're sensitive to the voice of the Spirit of God. You're listening. In fact, you want to hear the voice of the Spirit of God. You're listening to the voice of the Spirit. One thing I've noticed, the Lord talks to us second by second. He's talking to us all the time, especially if it's you're going to get into trouble. You can get into trouble. And that trouble could be big trouble. It could be a little trouble, just like maybe something happens and you have a negative feeling and you feel remorse. You feel, oh, I shouldn't have done that. Oh, I made this mistake, or something that would have a consequence. The Lord is that gracious. And in listening to him, he gives us direction. Go left, go right. Do it now. Don't do it now. Say yes to the person. Don't say yes. Respond now. Don't respond. Right? So it could be for little things like that that are even protective of us. Or it could be big things like big projects, like don't sin, don't do this terrible sin, don't go this way, don't make this into that thing that the enemy is telling you to do. Don't have that abortion, don't marry that, you know, don't go after somebody's husband. It could be big projects like that, right? Don't run around with those friends that are on drugs. It could be big things like that. It could be little things that are just like directing your life, in your everyday life. I'm telling you that I found that the Lord speaks to us second by second if we are listening. And that's the journey I'm on, is to be hearkening to the voice of the Holy Spirit. I want to be attuned. That's what I keep saying, Lord, I don't want to miss you. In fact, sometimes when I feel like I miss the Lord for little things, maybe he says, oh, you shouldn't have taken that turn on that street, and I took it. I know how I feel, right? Maybe I took it and then I experience some kind of negative consequence, right? So honestly, that's something I'm working on. I want to hear God second by second. Imagine the kind of fullness of life. And the word tells us here, he says, I will favor you. You know why? Because you're already in the right path. If you're doing what God has instructed you to do second by second, you're likely not going to get into any trouble. You're barely. It's going to be very minimal. So that's where the blessing is. You're already in God's will by listening to his voice. And I want to throw this in there. And he talked about trembling at his word. So we hear his word. And through hearing the voice of his Holy Spirit, we also hear his word through the Bible. That is so huge, especially at this day and age that we're hearing so much. Like I said earlier, we need to discern what is of God and what's not. And one way you can validate that is through the word. Let us spend more time in the word of God than we're hearing everything else. The media, some of us just sit by that news as if like it's our, I don't know. That's right. That's not right. As a Christian or somebody who wants, even if you're not a Christian, you want direction for your life that will produce life for you, true life, like a good life. Prioritize the word of God. Should we put our heads in the sand and pretend that we don't know that things are going on? I like period like for me periodically I would check on the news, right? So I have an idea what's going on. But I don't want to sit there for hours and absorb all the negative things and all the negative news and all the controversy and all of those things. You want to spend, you want to devote that time to the word of God. You want to honor the word of God above all of those things, right? You want to set your priorities right. You want to set your priorities right. You want your focus to be in God's word. Let me just say this real quick. Because when you spend time on other things, other forms of media and other kind of voices that are contrary to the will of God, you're going to find yourself moving in the area of sin without even realizing it. And you're moving right in the camp of the enemy. And he brings you to this place where the Lord says, and you did evil in my sight. You wouldn't even know when you go off track. You will gradually go off track without even realizing it. Because you're not soaking your soul in what you should be soaking your soul. You're one with God. This is the one you should be hearing from. Not honoring all of those things above the time. Some of us, that's what we do. We spend more time in everything else. And that we have such a challenge spending time in God's word. And the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. So we're just going to wrap it up here. I just want to encourage you. You know, one thing I want you to get for sure tonight is the Bible says that God wants us to hearken to his voice. Listen to his voice. Be submissive to his voice. Listen to his voice and obey his voice. Right? So you hear that by the Spirit of God speaking in on your inside. And you also you confirm that by spending time in God's word. Versus anything else. Prioritize God's word and the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Right now, I'm just going to pray for us real quick. If you know you're that one and this has been your lifestyle and it's been a struggle, the Lord is here for you, right? The Lord is here for you. He's going to minister to you. He's going to help you. One thing I've noticed with the Lord, if you really want to say, you know what? I don't want this lifestyle. I don't want to do things this way. He will help you. He will help you. If you're in the depths of your heart, you want to take a different turn. You want to go a different pathway, the pathway that honors God and will bring blessing and favor on your life. So we're going to pray right now. Dear Jesus, thank you for this precious time in your presence. Lord, we're here to just say we're sorry. We're sorry, we repent for not listening to your voice, going our own way. Lord, right now we just want we want you to be our guide. We want you to direct our pathway. The voice of a stranger we don't want to listen to. Father, we want to hearken to your voice. We want to do your will. We want to know your voice. Attune our spiritual ears, oh God, to know what's of you or what's not of you. Give us the grace, Lord, to hearken to your voice, to choose your will, to choose spending time in your word in the name of Jesus. Lord, we bless you. We thank you. We thank you. Let your spirit come upon us afresh, even as we pray right now. Glorify your name in our lives, oh God. Glorify your name in our lives. We surrender completely to you. We surrender. We surrender our hearts, our minds, our soul, our everything. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you for your love. It is well with us in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. It is well with you indeed. God bless you. Thank you for spending time with me on Claudia God Nugget for the day. God bless you. I look forward to connecting with you again. Soon. God bless. Bye-bye.